Hello everyone. Today I will share an interesting fact that a vitreoretinal surgeon used to do two Rhexis in one eye. Rhexis is controlled tearing of capsule. For the cataract surgery, we open or tear the capsule of the lens, what we call is the capsular Rhexis. For the controlled tearing or Rhexis of anti-capsule, either we take the help of retro-illumination. If the retro-illumination is not there, like in mature cataract, then we stain the capsule with Trypton Blue dye. For staining the entire capsule, we use Trypton Blue 0.025% concentration. To start the capsular Rhexis, we lacerate the capsule at one point and then we hold the capsule from one edge and then we start tearing capsule to the desirable size and shape. Second Rhexis we do on retina, where we peel the interlimiting membrane. Before starting peeling of ILM or interlimiting membrane, total posterior vitreous detachment induction is the must. Then on the exposed surface of retina or ILM, we instill the dye either in the presence of air or in the fluid. For staining the epiretinal membrane and the ILM, we use Trypton Blue 0.15% or Brilliant Blue G or BBG in combination with polyethylene glycol PEG. BBG has more affinity with the ILM. This was the case of macular hole with grade 3 nuclear sclerosis. Phaco surgery was done initially to clear the visual axis. Pars plana vitrectomy was done. PVD was induced before staining the ILM with the BBG under air. This surgery was being performed by Dr. Smriti Mishra, who is a vitreoretinal consultant at Sanai Hospital. After fluid air exchange, the ILM was nicked with the ILM peeling forceps. Then carefully under proper visualization, the torn edge of ILM held and Rhexis has been initiated. For initiating good controlled anterior capsular Rhexis, proper antechamber tamponade with the viscoelastic is the must. Any bulge or thrust on anterior capsule can create problem and one can get an extension of the capsular Rhexis towards periphery. Similarly, for good ILM peeling, pinch and grab technique is often being used. In this, first pinch the ILM with forceps and then let go. This enables the ILM to separate from the underlying retina. Next, use the forceps to re-grab the ILM and pull it in the circumferential manner, ensuring that both tines of forceps touch the ILM at the same time would make it easier to grab the tissue. Both anterior capsular Rhexis and ILM Rhexis require lots of practice and concentration. How did you find this video? Please comment and also subscribe my YouTube channel Sudhir Eye Coach for many more such interesting presentations and video. Thank you very much for inspiring me, and your comments mean a lot to me. Thanks for watching.